Hey, gun people and horsey people. I'm going to do some, I'm going to put some of this rust stuff on this thing. Somebody sent me, one of my viewers sent me this. And so this corrosive seal or whatever, I poured it a little bit in here. That's what it looks like. And I'm just going to paint it on this stuff here. This is all rusted. And I want to stop the rusting. So I am just going to paint this on here and hopefully stop the rusting. Now, some people may say they like the rusting better. These things over the time will start degrading and a little rust may be okay, but if you get too much rust, it starts eating away at the metal and it starts weakening it and it comes apart. So there's going to be some people that are like, oh, you should never stop the rust, that's antique, and that's, you know what? I put too much of the stuff in here. This goes a long way. I just put a little bit in here, and it's covering it pretty well. Now, this thing says go back after 15 or 20 minutes, and if you see any rust coming through or shining through, then you can put another coat. So you can tell I'm pretty liberally putting this on here. And we'll go ahead and do the exterior of the bale. Now I kind of like the spray on a little bit better because it gives that immediate black. This doesn't go all black unless it hits rust. So I don't know how this is going to turn out. And again, if it doesn't turn out like I like it, I'll just spray paint it with the other rust preventative that turns it all black. I have these two little things here, the screw and the bolt. Took me forever to get that off. Remember I told you that pro tip about wearing gloves when you do this? Guess what? I didn't do it. I got to grab a glove.
Better and not
shut up. I'm doing it now. Freaking cry babies.
We shouldn't have to watch you put on a glove. You should
shut up. You freaking, all you experts who don't freaking make videos telling everybody else how to make them. Okay. So this again is going to be outside, so I really don't want it to, oh, I got a lot on that one. So we're going to see, oh, I just splattered that everywhere, how this thing works. Now to the inside.
You should have down a mat and you should have eye protection. And
I really should have eye protection because I don't want this shit splattering my eye, but I'm not getting too wild and crazy out here.
But Rick, accidents happen.
Whatever. Okay. Get the inside, flip this over, get the other side. And that rust will sometimes, like the main here is kind of like fine, that rust will start taking that away. And the eyes and the ears and the nose part, if you don't kind of stop that rust. I know everybody would be like, you put water locks on everything. I put water locks on wood because it's great on wood. I put this rust preventative stuff because it's great at stopping rust. And in humid climates, you're going to get rust. And then if I want to put a second coat, I can. really want to make sure I get... I missed a lot down in here because I wasn't. This stuff has a little bit of odor. It's water-based. But overall, it's not too bad. I've got a window in front of me right here. Oh shit, I'm not even in a camera. So has this started bonding on here yet? Making sure I get a good covering. Alrighty. So I've got another little horsey out there that, now see, there was a little bit of rust coming through this key here in these grooves. I saw it. So I'm going to hit it with a second coat to make sure any rust coming out gets hit. Probably just should have thrown this in the liquid and pulled it out. So putting on this glove was a good idea because it definitely made it to where I can handle these things. Alrighty. And that's it to stop this rust. Now, I'm not going to paint this, but if I painted it with a Rust-Oleum that stops rust, it's kind of oil-based, most spray paints. That Rust-Oleum is oil-based, so that also helps stop rust. So if I wanted to paint this, I could, but I just want to stop the rust. And hopefully this is bonding into that rust and neutralizing it or whatever the hell it does with this little chemical stuff. Over and get the other side because the t-shirt is kind of soaking up some of this, but it's already kind of started its bonding process and anti-rusting. So even though it rubbed it off, I mean, when this stuff sticks in my hand, it like rubs, it turns into like a rubber coating, almost a rubberized coating on my hand. But on this, I'm not sure what it's going to turn into. And there might be other things. I'm not promoting this product. I'm not saying this is the only one. It's just this rust conversion crap. I was just turned on to it when I had to fix my... If you watch my video where I painted my smokestack on my fireplace, it worked really well. So I was like, man... That stuff stopped that rust in its tracks. Now, if I wanted to, I could take one of these and wipe this off before it dries, and it's already started its little kind of rust proofing. But I think by letting it soak in and stay wet, it's going to do a better job. But I can already tell that this was really rusty and brown and stuff, and now it's almost like got a coating just from this little time of this video. I'll put that back on there and just let it dry up. Smokey's over there watching me. You can tell it's leaving like a blue tint on that. I want to turn this over and get the inside of this again. I'll get the inside, then I'll do the outside one more time. So the inside, I can't tell if you guys can see that or not. It's got that blue tint. The t-shirt kind of sucked off this edge here. I'll be dead and gone before this thing rusts away, even if I didn't do this. But this will make it last longer. And these things usually go up in value as steel goes up and making it, materials. Plus, it looks kind of a... It's got a nice little horse with a little baby on it. It's a good little horsey thing. I don't know if I got that... little hole real good. And I'm thinking if you miss a little spot, it's not gonna be the end of the world. Of course, I'm sweating like a nun in church, or a whore in church. Is that what that goes? Nun in confession, whore in church? What's that saying? Sweating like a hooker on nickel night. Woo! It's freaking warm in this garage. I got my fan outside in the stall. I need to pull that out. All right, so you can kind of see the progress here. It doesn't take long to do this. And I'm just rolling it because this t-shirt is kind of absorbing it a little bit. But once it's on, that shit's on. These two little things here, if you can see, there are a couple washers between the bell. So you keep a washer between this, and it rings louder, I guess. It doesn't dull the sound. Okay, so I probably should hang this, but then I'm going to... No matter where I touch it or lay it, it's going to get a little bit. All right, so I'm going to... Again, this is water-based, so I'm going to go wash this off. It's not water-based once it hits your skin... and turns black with rust. The screwdriver's kind of rusty. I can just rub a little bit of this on it and it'll help stop that rust on that screwdriver. Let me hit it with the old brush. Hell, I'll hold it with this. Since I already have it out, we'll just throw that on a little rust conversion on the old screwdriver. Anything else? This thing doesn't look too rusty. But I'll hit it. Can't hurt it. So, we'll see how the old tool turns out. I'll come back after it dries and, give you an update. Rick, you're putting that on everything. Well, anything that's metal is going to rust. I mean, what the hell? What's the problem? Now, this thing, I think, is like copper or brass. So, I don't know if it works on here. I guess I can put a little bit on top here. Let's see what it does to this. Probably doing some chemical reaction, creating some freaking... disastrous chemical. Me and Moki will be found dead in the garage. Video camera will be playing. They won't want to post the video because it'll scare somebody. Woohoo! This is really dangerous and we can't show the video. Well, this little thing's got some little rust on it. See that little rust on there? Let's go ahead and get that kind of touched up here. All right. Get a little rust off that sucker too while I'm at it. All right, I'm gonna go rinse this brush and I'll come back when it's done. Okay, so Mokey's in here, it's hot. He's like, dude, what are you doing over there? You're making my house stink. Hi, Mokey Cat, what are you doing? He's like, Dad, I'm trying to help you with your project so you don't screw it up. I know, he's a good boy. Okay, so what do we got here is because it was so rusted, it looks like it turned a pretty good solid black. So I've got the light on up here, but it's not really, maybe it's just my angle. Is that coming through? So it's pretty much dried. I mean, it might take longer to dry, but now remember, I didn't paint this. I just put this rust stuff on it that turns black. So I'm just going to kind of inspect it here. Make sure I don't see any rust spots, which I don't. Now I'll put this sucker back together. There's a little bell ringer. These turn kind of black from that rust on that. I haven't tried to screw the nut on because it was hard getting it off. I don't know, that's pretty freaking hard. Mokey's at my feet. What are you doing, boy? So it appears that the nut and bolt kind of goes on pretty hard, but looks pretty good. So hopefully it'll stop that rusting on that. I'll get the two little rubber washers on here. That goes through there. Put the little nut on. The horses are outside looking at me like, dude, what are you doing in the garage? Are you getting us food? I'm working on this project, boys. Alrighty. Hook this on in there. Great little bell. Turned out pretty good. Now I'll go hang it up. See, I got a little bit of rust coming through right there. I might go ahead and just paint that a little bit. Since I already did my I already cleaned my brush. I'm going to use a Q-tip to do that. So I can just throw it away. So that looked like it had a little bit of rust right there. See if there's any other spots that I can touch up. Otherwise, it looks pretty good. I wanted to get the inside of these where I'm going to put the screws real good. Alrighty, it's ready to go get hung up. So that's my de-rusting 101. I de-rusted that, put some of that on it, turned black. And I de-rusted these and they turned black. And this, I don't know what it did. It made it kind of shiny. But I don't think it de-rusted it. It made it really smooth. I guess we'll end it there and I'll show you after I get it hung up. What are you boys doing? Alright. So Moki Cat's in here helping me. What are you doing, boy? He's like, Dad, get out of my workshop. Alright, so I got it hung up and you guys can take a look at it and see what you think, whether I should have left it. I know I'm going to have the purist tell me how I shouldn't have messed it up. So this is the final project here on this one. This is kind of what it looked like. Hell, that's hard to see. See the rust and everything. This bell over here is a little bit bigger. This one, so what do you think? Are y'all a Buddy gave it the seal of approval. You like it, Buddy? I know, you're a good boy. What about you, Ransom? Alright, so again, I did not paint this. I just put that rust converter on it and it turns it black. So I think I'm going to do this one because this one's rusting pretty bad. And I just don't want it to get all fragile and start rusting away. I know someone would be like, it's patina or whatever the hell they want to call rust nowadays to make it sound cool and authentic. So I'm going to do that one. I actually put some of that on this one because it was really getting rusty too. The dinner bell for the boys. And you can tell I only did the bottom here and I did not do the top part, which is pretty rusty. That's Smokey hitting the camera. Boy, I'm gonna beat you like a redheaded stepchild. I'm filming and you come ramming your head into the camera. So I should probably do the horseshoe. And I'm going to do that one. I'm not even going to wait for your input. I know everybody will be like, no, you should leave it. You're going to ruin it. The rust looks great. All right, whatever. I think the black rust protection looks pretty damn good, personally. All right, we'll see how that goes. Okay, here's the final rust proofing on that one. Final rust proofing on that one. Again, not painted, just put rough proof or rust, that corrosion protection on it. Give you a straight on view. This stuff does a pretty good job. I mean, it really knocks the rust down. Here comes trouble. So this one has a little baby pony on it. The other one down here on the end, it was painted. So I went ahead and put some on it. I went ahead and pulled it off and put that stuff on it. But since it was painted, it really didn't do anything. There was one little rust spot on here. But you can tell it didn't turn it black or anything because it didn't hit the rust directly. But I painted that whole thing just like I did, just like I painted this one. And painted that one. Alrighty. This is my little project. Mokey's at Muffy. He's got a beachy like stepchild. You gotta come out here and try to hit this camera. Every time I come out here. And I haven't seen my rabbit all day, and then the rabbit showed up, so the rabbit just got here too. I'll let y'all see him before I leave. So he just came in and got a little snack. I haven't seen him all day. All right, well, in that there on using a rust converter. Wind's picking up. It's kind of getting cloudy out here. It cooled off, so maybe we'll get a little rainstorm or something to cool the place off a little bit. All right, well, in that there.